Anjana. Today, let us learn a poem called Upagupta of 9th standard English. Yes. My dear students, this poem is written by Rabindranath Tagore, who has written our national anthem, Jana Gana Mana. Yes. Let us watch the picture of Rabindranath Tagore. Yes, see, this is the picture of Rabindranath Tagore. Rabindranath Tagore is the greatest India's modern poet, one among the modern poets, and was born in an affluent Bengali family in 1861 at Kolkata. Besides being a poet, he was novelist, essayist, and dramatist. Tagore was awarded the Nobel Prize for Literature in the year 1913 for his work called Geetanjali, which is a collection of poems, beautiful poems. Yes, he was the founder of internationally famous institution Vishwa Bharati at Shantiniketan. Yes, we have learnt about Shantiniketan in our previous class. Can we remember this? Yes, it was in our 8th standard, first lesson, that was a day in the ashram where we have learnt about much about Shantiniketan. Yes, which is having a unique way of teaching the children. Yes, unique means different from our formal education. That is, the children in Shantiniketan will not come to school like us, but they have their own taste and they will fulfill their taste by learning in the nature. Yes, that is Shantiniketan. His poetry is profoundly and unmistakably Indian. He restates the wisdom of India in verse by mingling love, friendship and music. Yes, we have seen the picture of Rabindranath Tagore. Yes, now after learning about the poet Rabindranath Tagore, who has written our national anthem Jana Gana Mana, let us move on to the poem Upagupta. Yes, the poem Upagupta is written by, as we have learned, written by Rabindranath Tagore, and here the person or the main character of this poem Upagupta is the follower of Lord Buddha. Yes, this is the picture of Lord Buddha. This is the picture of Lord Buddha. This is the picture of Lord Buddha, who was the founder of Buddhism. Yes, he, after his death, he had many followers in India. One among them was Upagupta. Yes, Upagupta was the, as we have already learned, Upagupta was the follower or the disciple of Lord Buddha. Yes, let us see the poem. Upagupta, the disciple of Buddha, lay asleep on the dust by the city wall of Mathura. Lamps were all out, doors were all shut, and stars were all hidden by the murky sky of August. Yes, let us learn about the poem. Yes, Upagupta, a person called Upagupta, was the disciple of Lord Buddha. Disciple means follower. Follower means he was following the principles of Lord Buddha. Yes, and he was sleeping on the dusty soil of the Mathura one day. Yes, during that time, all the lamps were out and all the doors were closed and all the stars were hidden by the murky sky of the August. August is the month of rainy season. As it was the rainy season, all the stars were hidden by the clouds, dark clouds, so that that was a dark night. And during that time, a person by name Upagupta was sleeping on the city walls, near Mathura. Yes, and during that August month, something happens to him, and let us see in the next stanza. Yes, whose feet were those tinkling with anklets, touching his breast? Of a sudden, he woke up startled, and the light from a woman's lamp struck on his forgiving eyes. Yes, when he was sleeping on the dusty soil of Mathura, near the gate of Mathura, yes, he was touched by some person whose handkerchiefs were tinkling. Tinkling means shining. That means shining. Yes, a person who has touched the person called Upagupta, that person's handkerchiefs were shining. Yes, and that person had touched his breast all of a sudden. Breast means chest. Yes, he woke up startled. Startled means shocked. When he was touched by somebody or some unknown person, he startled or he was shocked, and so that he shocked and wake up, and the light from the slam. Struck is for K-N-I-S-S. Yes, that person who has touched Upagupta was none other than a woman, and she was having a lamp, and the light from her lamp fell on the forgiving eyes of that person called Upagupta. Yes, so that, yes, that woman was none other than the, see the picture of dancing girl of Madura. Yes, we will come to know about the name of that dancing girl later. That was Vasavadatta. Her name was Vasavadatta. Yes, she was starred with jewels. Yes. After she had touched the body of that ascetic or Upagupta, she asked him, "Forgive me, young ascetic," said the woman. "Graciously come to my house. The dusty earth is not fit bed for you." The young ascetic answered, "Woman, go on your way." Yes. After she had touched the body of young ascetic, she asked the forgiveness of that person, or the young ascetic Upagupta. Yes, she asked him to forgive her. Said the woman, "Yes, graciously," and she requested him to come to her house or to visit her house, because that where the person or Upagupta where he was sleeping was not a suitable place for him, according to her. Yes, that was not a suitable place because that was a dusty place, or that place was covered with dust. So that she asked him to come to her house to sleep in her house, but he politely refused her invitation, saying that then the ascetic answered, "Woman, go on your way. Yes, this is not the time for me to visit your house. Go on your way, continue your way, or please go on your way," he asked her. Yes. When she politely asked him to come to her way, "Yes, I will come to your house, but this is not the right time," he says later. Yes, and politely he asked her to go on her way or continue her way towards her home. Yes, later when the time is right, "I will come to you." Suddenly the black knight showered its teeth in a flash of lightning. The storm growled from the corner of the sky, and the woman trembled in fear of some unknown danger. Yes, when she asked him to come to her house, but when he refused to accept the invitation given by that woman Vasavadatta, or dancing girl Vasavadatta, all of a sudden he told her that when the time is suitable for me, I will visit your house. He said politely, "I will come to you when the time is right. Yes, I will visit your house when it is necessary, or when the time will right." Suddenly the black knight showered its teeth in a flash of lightning. Yes, as we have already learned, yes, it was a month of rainy season. The lightning had taken place in that black night, and so that the storm was also occurred there, and from the corner of the sky she was trembled. Trembled means shaken. She was shaken, and she became afraid of the storm and the lightning, so that she decided to go to her home. After giving the invitation, polite invitation to Upagupta, she decided to go to her home again. Yes. A year has not yet passed. It was the evening of a day in April. In spring season, the branches of the wayside trees were full of blossom. The gay notes of the flute came floating in the warm spring air from afar. Yes, that as we have learned, that incident where Upagupta met a dancing girl, that was in the month of August. That was in the rainy season. A year has not yet passed. This incident where we are studying had occurred in the month of April. A year. Yes, 8 months have taken place. A year has not yet passed. It was evening of a day. During the time of evening, one day in the month of April, in spring season, April is the month of spring season, the branches of the wayside trees were full of blossom. Yes, all the branches of the trees were having tender leaves, and all the trees were full of blossoms or flowers, and at the same time gay or happy notes were heard from the flute, from the floating air, from the spring air from afar, from a long distance, or from the distance one can hear the beautiful notes of a flute during that period. Upagupta passed through the city gates. On that day, Upagupta was passing through the city gates. gates of Mathura and stood at the base of the rampart. Yes, as he was moving outside the city of Mathura, he stood at the rampart and was that a woman lying at his feet in the shadow of the mango grove. Yes, he was able to see a woman who was lying near his feet, in the shadow of a mango grove. Yes, when he was suddenly moving outside the city of Mathura, he was able to see a woman outside the city of Mathura. Yes. Yes, who was affected by a deadly disease called smallpox, and it was an infectious disease. That means that which will spread from one person to another person. So she was affected by that disease. She was driven out of the town. Yes. Yes. Let us learn the picture we have learned. This is the picture of a person who was affected by smallpox. Yes, they will have their scars and on the face, on the body of that person, they will have the sores on their body, and that is a contagious or the infectious disease which will spread from one person to another, so that the people of Mathura were not able to keep that woman in their city because that will spread to them. They were afraid of the fact that disease will spread to them, so that they had driven out that woman from the city of Mathura, so that she was lying outside the city of Mathura near the mango groves. Yes. Yes. Struck with the black pestilence, her body spotted with the source of smallpox. Yes, as we have learned, she was affected by the deadly disease called smallpox, which is a infectious disease, and she was hurriedly driven away from the town. Yes, she was driven away or sent away from the city of Mathura to avoid her poisonous contagion. Yes, to avoid the poisonous diseases spreading, they had driven her out of the city. A person who was a beautiful woman or a beautiful dancer a few months back has affected by the deadly disease called smallpox within 8 months. Yes, the ascetic sat by her side. She took her head on his knees. Yes, the ascetic, or Upagupta, who was invited by that woman 8 months back, has sat by her side. Where he is sitting beside a person who was driven away by the whole village. But ascetic was able to sit by her side and took her head on his knees, and he had taken her head on his knees, and he is able to treat her, that woman, because she was affected by the deadly disease called smallpox. Yes. And moistened her lips with water and smeared her body with sandal balm. Yes, that person, Upagupta, moistened her lips. Yes, he provided her water because she was deprived of the water and she was feeling thirsty, so that he provided her the water and smeared her body with sandal balm. Yes, he smeared the sandal balm to prevent the pain of her body. And who are you, merciful one? Yes, she was unable to recognize that person, so that she asked that person, or Upagupta, who are you? She was unable to recognize anyone of that city. Asked, and who are you, merciful one? Who is that person who is providing water and smearing sandal balm to me? That was the concern of that woman. She wanted to know that person who has helped her. Yes, asked the woman, the time at last has come to visit you. Now he is remembering the 8 months before incident where she had invited him to her home. Now he is saying, at last the time has come to me to visit you or visit your home, and I am here. That is why I am here. Yes, yeah, you have asked me to come to your house, but I was unable to attend, or I was unable to come to your house during that time. But the time has, yes, I have already told you, the time has come to me to visit you or meet you. They said the young ascetic. Yes. Yes, now let us learn or summarize the poem. Yes. Yes, this poem of 9th standard, Upagupta, is written by Rabindranath Tagore, who is the author of our national anthem Janaganamana, and National Anthem Janaganamana, and who is the founder of Shantini. Niketan, and here the poet is telling about a follower of Lord Buddha. The Lord Buddha, who is the follower of Lord Buddha? That is Upagupta. As we here we can see the followers of Lord Buddha. They will dress like this and they will have a shaven head like this. Yes, this is the model or the model picture of the followers of Lord Buddha. Yes. As here we can summarize the poem. Yes, a person by name Upagupta, who was the follower of Lord Buddha, one day sleeping near the dust or the soil, the dusty soil near the Mathura during the night time, dark night time, during that time he was touched by a person who was unknown person, touched by an unknown person, so that that unknown person was having a lamp in their hand. In their hand, so that after seeing the person who had touched his body in that light of that person, he recognized that was none other than the person called dancing girl of that city called Vasavadatta. And she, after recognizing that ascetic, she asked him to come to her home, because that was, according to her, that was not a suitable place for him to sleep. During that night of rainy season. So she asked her, politely requested him to come to her house and take a rest in her home. But he politely said that it is not the right time or ripe time for me to visit your house. One day I will come to your house when the time is right, he says. Yes. Yes, here you can see the picture of dancing girl. That is the picture of a dancing girl, imaginary picture of a dancing girl called Vasavadatta. Yes, the dancing girl was wearing a jewels and wearing a pale blue mantle. Mantle means loose cloak or dress, and she was proud of her youth, and she lowered her lamp. When she had lowered her lamp, she saw or recognized the face of Upagupta, who was austerely beautiful. As forgive me, said she asked that person, or Upagupta, she asked him the forgiveness of that person, because she had touched the body of that person and requested him to come to her house. Graciously come to my house, the dusty earth is not fit bed for you, she said. So she says, yes, the young ascetic answered, woman, go on your way. Yes, he says politely that woman, continue your journey or go to your home. This is not the right time for me to come to your house. He says, when the time is right, when the time will ripen, I will come to your house. I will come to your house, because this is not the right time for me to visit your house. And in a, during that time, a flash, during that time, suddenly lightning and the storms will take place. After that incident, she went to her home, trembled, being feared. After getting feared, she went to her home. Yes, after that incident had taken place in the month of August, a year has not yet passed. During that month of April, yes, in the spring season, when the branches of the wayside trees were full of blossom and the flowers, yes, one more incident had taken place in the life of Vasavadatta and Upagupta. Yes, one day, Upagupta was passing through the city gates of Mathura. During that time, a woman was lying under the mango groves, and he was able to see that woman, and he could not recognize that woman, because she was affected by the deadly disease called smallpox, and she was driven out of the city because of the spreading. The people of the city Mathura were afraid of the deadly disease, and they were to prevent that deadly disease spreading, they had driven her out of the city, and she was not at all recognized by that person or Upagupta. So that even though he was not able to recognize her, he went near her and took her head on his knees, and he treated her like a known person, and he provided her the water, because she was feeling thirsty. As she was feeling thirsty, he provided her the water, and he smeared her body with a sandal balm. Yes. Like a known person, he moistened her lips with water and smeared her body with sandal balm. Who are you, merciful one? After she was affected or she was smeared by sandal balm, she was very much pleased with that person's treatment. She asked that person, who are you? Who is that person who is treating her? She wanted to know that person. that art class went during that time, that ascetic said that this is the right time for me to visit you. When you asked me or when you asked me to visit your house, that was not the right time, so that I did not visit your house. Now I have visited your house because it is the right time for me to visit your house and treat you. Yes, he says, I am here, replied, yes, this is the time at last has come to visit you and I am here. That is why I am here, he said. Yes, in this way, the person, Upagupta, answered the questions or fulfilled the desire of Vasavadatta, who was the dancing girl of Madura. Yes, in this way, we can summarize this poem. Thank you.